just another day in Wonderland.
To watch the sun come up and watch the day start. That's my favorite time. I like being up in the early morning and watch things start up. Try and get to the barn at 5 a.m. in the morning and milk and feed, clean up. At 5 in the afternoon, we start milking again. And then you generally finish up around 8 o'clock at night. Normal people have no concept of what's involved. There's a lot of times when you go out and there's a water line broken and the whole barn's flooded. You go out and there's a cow having trouble having a calf. That's where we got the name Daily Crisis Farm. You just never know what you're gonna run into.
Go on, you're worrying your mom. Come on.
So most people my dad's age are getting ready to retire and thinking about, you know, buying a house in Florida, and my dad's thinking, oh, I gotta get up in the morning to milk cows again, you know? It's in your blood, so I mean, it's what you wanna do, it's what you enjoy, but there's not necessarily a sense of retirement from it.
People like myself, we're all dying off. And there's not enough young people wanting to come back in. 50 years ago, a farm this size would have had a full-time hired man. He would have been able to support his family, and you would have been able to support yours with enough money coming in. And I say, we take better care of our animals, not just we, I'd say dairy farmers in general, take better care of our animals than a lot of people take care of their grandparents.
What's her name?
This one? Emmy Lou. Oh, just come up with it. They're like naming a child, I suppose. They've taken care of my family. They put two kids through college, and they employ my middle daughter.
She's our queen of the barn.
They take care of us, so we have to take care of them. I guess that's the bottom line.
There's a misconception in the world that, you know, we're just farmers with pitchforks, and people don't realize, like, Dad went to college for this. You know, we're nutritionists, we're veterinarians, we're electricians, we're jack of all trades in order to run the business that we have. We don't just milk cows.
I like the sound that they make when they chew the hay. It's like a crunching, I don't know. I just like that. That's Willa. She can smell the feed coming and she gets very excited. That's her singing down there. Everything goes up except our income goes down. You can't make enough money to buy the equipment that you need to improve. Unless things change in the next year or two, it's going to be dramatically different than what it is now, because most of the small farms are going to be gone. It makes me angry that rather than trying to find an answer to solve the problem, they're just telling you, don't blow your brains out.
The farmer is a resilient to the point of stubborn creature, and we are a self-help community. We take care of our own, we take care of each other, and so it doesn't always make the news. It doesn't always come out because we just take care of it.
I drink more milk than I do water, actually. The best part is the family. That's the absolute best part of it. Being together ever since they were tiny and watching them grow up.
Is this our official butter?
Yep.
Is it good?
It's magnificent.
Well, considering you put enough on here for 8 people.
No. Being together and doing all kind of stuff together. And then working together with them as they get older.
Man, I look old. I look young and strong in those pictures.
Yeah. I did what I wanted to do, and now they have to do what they want to do. I'm not going to try and hold them back. everything that you have is tied up and invested in dairying, the equipment, the feeding systems, the manure handling systems, everything you own has no value. If we were to sell out, we wouldn't have enough money to last 2 or 3 years. See everything that you've worked for 30, 40, 50 years, and in some cases that your father and your grandfather worked for, just to suddenly be completely blown up, it's very upsetting. Very, very upsetting.
Go on, get out.
There's always going to be dairy farming in the United States, whether or not it's going to be on a scale where people like us can continue.